Hey Arrow, hello. How are you doing? I'm fine too. Thanks for asking. I really hope that doesn't end up now in Reset Village. The guy I had to reset right now a scary amount of times. Which is never a good sign. If you keep being purple, then all of my mobs are purple. Yeah, JTB, Pitted, and Crystal Beauty. Maybe. Actually grabbed too much ammo, but whatever. Not gonna change anything. Like, I could have skipped one ammo there. Because I already got a random drop in the village. But yeah, it doesn't really change anything. Hey, Finem. I'm doing fine, thanks. How about you? Sorry guys, no hugs for you. Don't tell me how many viewers I have. That's distracting. Yeah, that's fine. Still appreciate it that you stopped by. God damn it, Arrow, stop spoiling. I don't really care how you call that. Like, some people make such a big deal out of it if you call it soccer or football. Oh well, I don't care.
What are you selling? What are you buying?
Are the items that I grab in boxes and stuff? Yes, they are there all the time. Like, I don't really have to rely on any random drops or so. So yes. Most stuff that I grab will be there every single run. But yeah, some boxes are random too. But yeah, the ones that I grab will be consistent. Because it would be pointless then. Because you never know what is in. Alright, see you tomorrow then. Oops, ah, still got the bird. If you miss the bird, you pretty much just have to shoot again. And you have a pretty good chance getting the correct one. I guess backup strategy. camera going crazy. Well, Leon already has his boyfriend in the mines. You pretty much just have to shoot immediately. Like, you aim and hold the shoot button down, and then you will hit him all the time. They are on the same level than you, like, when you start aiming. It's not hard. Just make sure you're not too far away. Oh shit, I missed. It could be bad. Alright, he dives here and you should be 3 hits away from death. So as long as I don't miss a spear here, it should be kinda fine still. There he is. Yeah, alright, that's fine. I'm gonna lose a bit of time here, but I expect that at the Lago. Like, being +7 is okay. It's 7 p.m. and 20 minutes. Great idea, Kale. Gonna have to try that. Yeah, that's a small out of bounds glitch. Like, when you jump down there in the correct spot, you land outside of the map and can skip a small part. Like, you basically only skip jumping over the boxes again and avoid one wave of enemy. It saves between 10 and 15 seconds. Depends on how fast you do it. Yeah, I think I saw that movie, but it's been a while, so I don't really remember much. I have no clue, Elik, to be honest. I don't really remember the movie. So I don't know which version it was. If I had to guess, I would say the newer one. But not sure. No clue. So many orange names. Like right now my chat is completely orange. So I actually have to read your names and can't just look at the color. Oh my god, hey Sleepwalker. Yep, another one. And there's Endgamer with the combo breaker. Please work. Of course, it doesn't work. That's such a stupid trick. Hey, XF, hello. Whoa, he almost hit me. Kind of predicted my movement there. I'm gonna do that classy cabin again. I feel safer doing that. Oh, hello guys. A lot of people in here. That's good. Stop it.
Are you trying to kill me?
Hey guys. Off my stairs. Die. Sagas are so stupid, like it's so random how much damage they take. Come on, man. And already. What the hell? Oops.
What the no?
That gold split. That was bad.
Wait.
Follow me. Yeah, what can you do? Why do I miss the double chain hit today? Like, on the first skate it's easier actually than on the second one. Yeah, that was crazy. But yeah, that happens once, and after that, you only get bad splits again. Like, that was a 2 minutes and 20 seconds cabin, around that. Like, it's not completely horrible, but it's of course not good enough to compare with my 2 minutes and 5 seconds cabin from my PB. Hey Fraskable, thank you. Get ready for the most important part of the run.
Follow me. Wait.
Yeah, to be honest, on GameCube it's really hard to see. Like, when I played GameCube I had pretty much the same problem. Especially if your TV is small. And it's even harder. You just have to hope that you actually hit. I mean, if you have a feeling for aiming at this game, which you get over the time, is not too bad. But yeah, I understand him. It's hard. I really want to find out why sometimes I only have to knife him once.
Are you okay, Leon?
I'm not sure if I'm actually saving time here, cause I missed the double chain hit at the Algigante. And I also made a mistake at the start when I hit the guide button of my controller. Like, I watched a bit of the cutscene.
So do your guys hear any background noises? If so, and if it's too much, I'm gonna close my window again. Just let me know, please. Yes, pizza.
What are you buying?
Okay.
Come back anytime.
Follow me.
Yeah, you can post whatever you want. I don't care, just don't post anything stupid. Like, I don't really have rules for my chat. Yeah, kind of arrow. Oh shit, that was my bad. Got too close to that guy. That was pretty good RNG there, actually. Like, they opened the door for me and I could shoot one immediately to also stun the other guys. Hi, Kale. See you later. Alright, water room hype. Best room in the game. I guess some enemies can be scary when you fight them the first time. Especially Verdugo. I mean the guy in the elevator. Where you have to wait. Leave me alone. Alright, good. So yeah, reloading the room here like I did makes the enemies kind of blind in this room. We don't really know why it happens, but yeah, they can't see me anymore unless I get closer to them. This way, yeah, the Grank singer here is much easier because I don't have to take care of enemies.
Look, there's a crank over there.
And yeah, reloading the checkpoint. Makes the enemies behind me disappear.
Watch out for me.
Well, the flash wouldn't stun them like all game long there. Like, this is a very long sequence here. So it wouldn't do too much. Well, you mean when I use the crank? If you mean when I use the crank, it can work if you throw flash grenades, but there are also shield guys, which make that a lot harder. Like, if you wanna go super risky, you use flash grenades. But that's for single segmented, most of the time, really too much of a risk. Oops. Did I grab it? I don't remember. I hope. Oh, it doesn't matter. And no, I don't do the rifle reload anymore. Like, it doesn't save any time. It actually costs a ton. And it's kind of scary, because it happened multiple times to me that I actually got grabbed while I was doing it. And yeah, it doesn't gain you anything, to be honest. So I don't see the point. It looks nice, but it doesn't really have a use. So besides the sword room, this was a pretty good chapter. Like, pretty much perfect water room. Yes, she can. It happened to me multiple times. Like, the red guy can get her. Maybe it's me being bad. Or I don't know. But yeah, that's the main reason why I don't like doing it anymore. It's a risk that I don't have to take. I gain nothing from taking the risk. So why would I? Well, the first Modesto Doris area is not too bad most of the time. Like, it can still be trolley sometimes, but most of the time it's the easiest one. Like, that was very clean. Also have perfect timing here. But it doesn't happen all the time. Like, sometimes I get hit. But yeah, in a perfect world you don't get hit, of course. There's another glitch upcoming here. Basically, I throw an incendiary grenade at the correct spot and it prevents the red guy from running away. Because normally you are supposed to chase him all over the map here. This way I don't have to do that. But you have to watch the cutscene here, or he will disappear. Nice, another critical. It's the second one today. Yeah, it saves a bunch of time, because you don't have to go after the key. Quite a few people here. I probably have to shoot them. Oops, that's not what I wanted. Yeah, no way I get past them. It's fine. Like, when you activate that button in that small room there, it makes 5 guys spawn on the bottom floor. But if I want to, I can still play this game normal. I don't have much trouble with that. Like, a lot of people have the problem if they speedrun something, they just can't go slow anymore. I guess if you play platformer like Super Mario, I understand that. But in this game, yeah. See no problem with playing it normal. But this is a really good chapter so far. Like, the only bad thing was that I had to shoot down the two guys there with the TMP. If the dogs are nice here, I should be able to save some time. Like, there are two spots where you can actually hit me. Because when I stop for picking up the item, Leon stops the first good moment. They get a chance to attack you like that. And it's random if they get you, you just have to hope that they don't. But yeah, this time they got me. But if you play a game a lot, you wanna find some new ways of enjoying it. And speedrun is one of these ways. Like, I played this game already like 50 times at least before I started speedrunning it. So it's something new. Like, you enjoy the game in another way to see how fast you can beat it. Oops. Yeah. Movement arrow. Like, I don't think there's a correct way to play a game. As long as you have fun, it's fine. Oh shit. That's bad. Shit, 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 shit. Not many people play normal. Like, I personally would prefer normal over pro. But yeah, you don't really have much competition. Because most people play pro. Don't know why. It's just something that is like it is. Like, before I started running pro, I did also normal. Yeah, you can link, I don't mind, as long as it's nothing bad. Go ahead. Well, not everyone has their runs on speedruns.com. But yeah, a lot of people upload there, but not everyone. Kinda sad that I lost time in my last sprint. But hey, it was my own fault. And I also got some bad RNG on the bridge. I might save a bit time back here, hopefully. Like, I'm happy with every single time save. Alright, best chapter hype. Totally not random. Yes, there is. On Pro, the enemies are more predictable because they will be always super aggressive. And on Normal, they are more random. Because Normal has a in-game difficulty adjustment, which means when you take damage, the game gets easier and stuff like that. But it doesn't really mean the game gets easier to complete in the end. Like, enemies on Normal will do stuff that they won't do on Pro, and it's a lot more random. Like, sometimes you don't really know what you have to expect from the next enemy. They can do weird stuff. Well, yeah, you catch something like that when you, like, try running past enemies. Like, on Normal, they are more likely to let you get past them than on Pro. Yeah, the Night Room is a good example. Like, on Normal, unless you pretty much never got hit until that point, on Normal, the Knights will move pretty slow. And on Pro, they are running all the time. So on Pro, the Knight's Room is, in most cases, harder than on Normal. It's possible that you get the hard Knights on Normal, but it basically means you never got hit until that point. Like, you will see some. On Normal, the Knights walk really slowly. You have all the time in the world to shoot them. While on Pro, missing just a single shot can be very bad. Because they are so fast. And stuff like that can also kill your run if you mess it up. Also, later in the game, it's more like it has a higher potential of getting one shot than a normal. Like, many people later on can just kill you in one hit. Which is not really the case on Normal. Hey, Xeno. Hello. Yeah, it's a bit faster doing it outside the room, because you have a better position where you can aim at them faster. Like, when you go into the room, you end up in the middle of the room, which makes it harder to, like, hit all four of them really quickly. So you do it from outside. Yeah, I guess I could beat mine all the time. But I also have to do a few D-Rust runs. Do not try this at home. I'm pretty much the only runner who does that strategy here. It's super risky, but it looks nice, so I do it. No, not the handgun ammo. Not the handgun ammo, Leon. Everything but the handgun ammo. Shit.
Please no troll. Alright, that's kind of fine. Like, I had to switch to the incendiary next anyway. That's fine that I missed one shot there. But you see how fast they move, so even missing one shot can be critical. Yeah, handgun ammo is the best. Alright, I'm back where my last good run died, in the Novistolores area. So let's hope it goes a bit better this time. Because, as I said before, this room is the most random one in the whole game. You just have to be lucky. There's no secret to it. What is this guy doing? Get away. Alright, that was much better than the first time. Oh yeah, true, Engama. I forgot about that one. You're right. So the scythe guys here can one-shot me with every single attack. So this is a really, really scary area. Especially when I come down from the clock tower again. Because there's one guy that is pretty much in a dead spot. And he can hit me very easily. And if he does, head gone. More tunnel. Nice, I stunned there. That's the guy I was talking about. With the kick, I stunned the archer, which is really good. But then he can't shoot me randomly. Pretty good chapter so far, actually, besides that one miss at the knights. Oh, how did I dodge that? That's scary. Totally expected to get hit there. Yep, I guess so. It's the improved archer strategy.
Welcome. Got some, what are you selling? Thank you. What are you buying? Thank you.
Yeah, I shoot a rocket launcher at them, which kills the left one, and then I shoot the right guy once with the sniper, which kills him. And now I can use the Deadman glitch, which makes me run 50% faster. Basically how this works is, you equip the Striker shotgun, then you start aiming, and before the red laser pointer appears, you switch out your weapon, and then you run faster. But it gets cancelled by a lot of things, like taking damage, opening doors and stuff. So you see me a lot of weapon switching now because of that, because I want to run faster. Ah, shit. Alright, getting hit by the second one is not too bad. Like, getting the first one is more important. Ah, that's a bad position. I have to run away from him or I hit myself. I'm not sure if I'm saving time, to be honest. All right, a bit. All right. Not much, but it's fine. It's better than nothing.
Welcome. Got some water you buying. Come back anytime.
My inventory is a bit messed up now, unfortunately. It's fine again. Oh. So yeah, now comes the next glitch. Basically, you're gonna use the zip line here twice in a row while Deadman activated, which makes me run faster. And then I can get out of the room pretty much. Like, the zip line transports you the same distance all the time, and when you use it the second time, it's not all the way up again. And this way, you end up out of the room. You can skip the two giants with that. Nice, got all of them. Nice, that was really good. Happy with that. Well, not this run, yeah, that's true. Well, most of the time I reset early on, unfortunately. But the last chapter of the game is actually the most random one in the whole game, so it happens a lot that you lose a run, like, right at the end. Because you get bad RNG. Which is kind of bad, like, you can't do anything about it. Just have to hope. Like, that's also a reason why an early lead is kind of important. Yeah, the chapter before the last. There's no way to speed up this chapter here, so you just have to wait. Ah, crap. Damn it. Grandma made it in. Hello, lady. Gonna see. I bet this is handgun ammo. It's always handgun ammo. But it disappeared, nice. Yeah, in this case it was actually good because I didn't have to grab it. It's kind of weird bug in the game, like it won't attack you if you're in the middle minecart there at the end. Alright, give me a second. I have to take a bathroom break. I'm gonna be right back. Alright, I'm back. Sorry about that. But yeah, at some point you just have to go. Sorry again. I don't care if it's a lot. Like, other people do it too. I know Moss does it sometimes. So whatever. Like, it's not like I've tried a section again or anything, like in segmented. I just stopped for like a minute or two. I think that's fine. Grenade! And there's my handgun ammo. God damn it. So I could actually save quite some time on this chapter if I get a really good elevator. But unfortunately I'm not the best at elevator. So I can never count on that. Like, it doesn't matter how much I practice it. In runs I rarely get a really good one. Right, here we go. One of the hardest parts of the game, in my opinion. Here we go. That was really good. So yeah, the goal there is to pretty much shoot them down from the elevator so it keeps moving. No! I never choke on that.
I should still save time. Maybe. No, not really. Damn! I never feel Salazar run. It was like 10 second time loss.
What are you buying?
I mean, it's still fine, but yeah. I would have saved time if I didn't fail Salazar, like a complete idiot. No, I wanna throw it away. I had to make space there for some items, so I threw a green herb away, because I have so many heal items. I didn't fail a Salazar in a while in a run. Feel really bad about that. Like, for me, Salazar is really easy. Yeah, I can still PB. Yeah, sorry if I don't explain too much anymore right now. But I have to focus. Gonna grab that grenade when I come back. Don't have space for it right now.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry if my game sounds weird right now. I'm gonna fix it in a second. When I kill the enemy here. Didn't see that my audio program messed up. It's gonna be fine again in 2-3 seconds. Right now. Sorry again about that. God damn it, it did it again. Sorry. I don't know why my audio program sometimes messes up like that. Sorry, guys. I have no idea why it does that. Fuck you. That was a really dangerous room. Cause it can go wrong really easily. But it worked out. Yeah, I can't promise that audio program, like that problem doesn't occur again. But yeah, sorry if it happens again. I don't know how to fix it right now. Behind us! I try my best to restart it as soon as possible when it happens again. I know it's annoying. Yeah.
I think it has something to do with my cable.
To you.
Sorry, I'm late. I have to try to focus. And I don't know if I would what I would do. Sorry. Hey Logan.
What are you buying? Come back anytime.
ago. Is that what they told you?
You're the one who kidnapped Ashley.
You got young quick, as expected. After all, you and I both know where we come from.
What do you want?
The sample settler developed, that's all.
Leave Ashley out of this!
Oh, I needed her to buy Sadler's trust in me. Like you, I'm American.
You got her involved just for that?
Talk. Die, comrade!
Ada!
Well, if it isn't the bitch in a red dress.
Looks like we have the upper hand here.
You may be able to prolong your life. But it's not like you can escape your inevitable death, is it?
You knew each other?
More or less. Maybe it's about time you told me the reason why you're here.
Maybe some other time.
Thank you. straight.
What are you buying?
Thank you.
Come back anytime.
What is it that you fight for, comrade?
Prepare for your death, Leon.
on, sweetheart.
Sorry if I'm not talking. Yeah, I really had to focus. Sorry about that. Nice. Thanks, guys.